Okay, this is a description of the map Nordfriesisch Marsch, or however it's pronounced. I've written it in the topic title, and here we are at the home base. There's some great demand for something down there at the depot. I think it's potatoes. It's not worth thinking about. Anyway, so this is the home base. I've used a number of mods and also modified a number of vehicles to suit my needs. Some of the mods are the silo extensions, which are 300,000 litres each, and it's better than the default 100,000 litres, because if you use the default 100,000 litres, which is in the game, then this place would be totally crowded with silos and I wouldn't be able to get to or from the load and pickup points. I mean the dump and pickup points. So anyway, here we are. This is Nordfriesisch Marsch. I don't care about that because I also, this is the seeds and the bloody fertilizer thing, which I don't care about because I've got the placeable seed bags and the placeable fertilizer bags, which are they're never ending. They never will run out. You just drive your tractor next to them, the sower, and then you load up. So now in this game, let's go to the shop. Yes, here we go. So you've got your usual stuff that you can sell, and you've also got compost at sell point 150, which is another mod which I'll show you in a minute. I'll get a lot for that, but I have to use it. And flour, sugar, bread, crates of beer, barrels of beer, empty pallets, skim milk, which is not the same as the normal milk, which is automatically sold, so you've always got to get it before 12 o'clock at night. Butter, sarn, don't know what it means. Anybody that knows can tell me. Quark, don't know what it means. I've tried both of those in Google Translate from German to English, and it just doesn't answer. Yogurt, pallets of paper, rolls, which are required for the dairy products, and cardboard cartons, which are required for the fruit products, and the fruit products are apples, pears, cherries and plums, and they're all saleable at the supermarkets, the two supermarkets. Okay, now one of the major points in this game is that wood pallets are needed for everything. So I'll show the sawmill first, and that's down here. Not needed for everything, but needed. Okay, so here's the sawmill. Now the sawmill's not currently working because I don't have any logs in it. But what the sawmill does is produce these long sticks of wood, which you then back into here and up unload. And you do that with these pallet loading automatic machines, which are mods. You can find them yourself. Auto pallet loader, just type that. And God, I've got too many. I mean, I can't fit them into there because that's almost full. I could probably fit, you know, this much, just this much here, but the rest of it, it's just going to build up. I wish I could sell it, because I need that sawdust. Anyway, so you drop your logs in over there, which I just told you, and then they get run through the blades, come out here, and get automatically loaded onto pallets, and they become pallets of wood, which you then take over to the pallet making machine, and you dump the wood into there. I'll give you an example. Let's get this out of the way. Now, one thing I do is always put that in a state of picking up pallets, which means that this gets full, this pallet truck, whilst the pallets are being formed. So when the thing gets full, I drive it away, because there's a bug with this game in which you can lose pallets and they just randomly appear elsewhere on the map. So I'm just going to put this over here for the moment so I can show you the wood loading regime. I've only got two pallets on this, but anyway, not much wood. I think it'll accept that, so we'll go around here. I might zoom out a bit. You see, the only reason I'm posting this is because you've got to work it out yourself in the game. Unload. See how we had one unloaded there, and unload again. I think it's full. I'll press Y for unload. Nah, it's not going to take it. Right, anyway, so that's where you put the sticks of wood, and they turn into that. Yeah, 220,000. You go up to the computers to work out how much you've got. So, I've only got... Oh, wait there. Wood chips, boards, pallet, boards. 62%, so that should be unloadable. Let's go here, and let's put it at the back and unload it again. No. Just unload, no. You can actually back the thing through it. So it's not going to accept it, why not? Oh, anyway, you've always got to work your way through little bugs in this. Anyway, the wood... the sawmill produces wood chips as a byproduct, and it uses the same wood chips as fuel, and it, you know, very fruitiously or serendipitously produces more wood chips than it needs for the fuel. But anyway, the thing's not going at the moment, so I'll just show you this mod, which is the automatic log picker-upper, and means you don't have to buggerize around with let me turn this around. These things can be confusing. God, this is arduously slow. Right, let's get around. Switch him on. Set the cut length for 8 metres. Bring it down a bit. Bring that around, hold in the left. Things getting me a load. Closest over to that tree. You can't see the right. Right. Lift. Turn to the side. I'll just zoom out a bit. Don't ever get out of this while you've got a tree in it, because it'll just drop the tree and you'll never be able to pick it back up again. You'll have to do it all manually with a chainsaw. Okay, so now, obviously, I'm just choosing the closest tree. Get the stump cutter out to get rid of that, but I'm not going to do that because everybody knows how to do that. So this is a mod. I'm not going to be bothered going into detail about it. But just if you want to type auto log loader. So now, if I say B, start auto load, I can see that there's O, it's already on the left hand side, so that's perfect. Watch how it picks them up. Come on, get on, get on, get on. Okay, this is only two logs. What you've really got to do is plant yourself a forest, which I've got, except I can't be bothered going all the way up there, because it'd be confusing as to where I am on the map. Okay, so you take logs here, and then press X for start unload, and they're automatically loaded onto that. But that's just a small amount, I mean, really small amount, just to show you how it goes. Pardon me. And it always takes a while for the game to register. Pardon me. Well, I've got emphysema, I'm an old man. So let's speed the game up a little bit. 1600. Okay, now we'll bring it back down to speed 1. And that's what it does with the logs. So even though I've only loaded this, and you've got a constant supply of sawdust building. And even though there's only two logs represented there, oh god, I'm going to have a bloody coughing fit. This is no good. Anyway, so that's how to do that. Then it produces those things, as I said, and you take them around and you put them over there, and then you take your pallets off to the things that need pallets. Now, the first thing that needs pallets is the brewery. So if we go down to the brewery, this is the brewery. Brewery needs 200,000 water for both the barrels and the crates. And it also needs hops in both these things. So that's the barrel hops. It's a bloody nuisance with Courseplay, this, because never gets it right. You've always got to kind of do it manually. And there's the crate hops. Here is the barley one. I'm less than 50,000. It goes up to 500,000. And here I'm 51,000, and that's wheat. And that produces the crates. So I think, anyway, I'll correct myself if I'm wrong. So here are some barrels still in production. I tend to let them get full and then back in a pallet collector, which is absolutely a hassle given the space that you've got. And here are crates, and you dump empty pallets that you pick up from the sawmill into there, and you dump more into there. They take 100,000. Over here I have bought up the pallets because I've got Courseplay, which is called sawmill to brewery, whereas I pick up a large load of pallets and have it continuously go back and collect more. So here are the crates that I've produced. No, the barrels. There's one on the side, but anyway, I couldn't be bothered. I really don't like the look of it though. And I dump the crates over here. And one important thing for me is to keep everything separate, because I don't want things getting mixed up. One flaw of these pallet collectors is if you dump things too close to each other, it really doesn't discriminate as to what it picks up at all. You don't need to give any pallets to the bread. Here's the bread up here. I'm just going to walk up here. Come on, come on, come on, come on. There's a harvester in limbo because I'm starting to get a bit sick of the game. I've got a water tower there, which I feed the tanker with. The tanker's generally just has to go to there to pick up the water. And I've got 102,000 out of 200,000. Unload the flour. I wonder if it needs any more flour. Let's just see. Work position. Unload. No, it doesn't need. Wait there. Unload. No, it's not going to do it. So it doesn't need any more of that. And I've got two larger pallet collectors, which I've only just started the game, so I've got to put them back into collect mode. And they start. Whoops, not that. Sorry. When you start off the game, they're all not in collect mode. But if I put this into collect mode, then it'll stay collecting pallets even when I'm out of it. It's not like I have to be with it. So, in order for it to pick up the pallets of bread as they're trolleyed along. I'll just give you an example of that. It speeds up the production of the game. So, here we go. I've got it going at 120 speed. Come on, move, 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 move. Build another pallet. Push it out. 3,333. When this number gets to 5,000, it'll all move along. Come on! I haven't got much time on this bloody bit. Okay. And you'll see that disappeared onto that truck. So this one isn't... Whoops, let's put the speed down. This one's now full. But I'll wait until they're both full. And the reason I do that is because it's just so much more efficient. I don't have to keep backing down and picking up all the pallets. And a bug in this game is that you do lose bread pallets. If you pick up every pallet when it's full and it starts producing another pallet before you drive away, you'll lose one pallet off your pallet truck and you will not know where the hell it's going to appear. It may appear right in the middle of one of your fields. So here is my supply of bread so far. I had so much bread before and it took me hours to sell it. It almost literally hours. It took me about 50 minutes. This is my flour. I don't really need any more. And flour is the thing I take over there to the bread factory with water in order to produce bread, which I can then sell. And here's the flour factory. It's all completely full, but I don't care because I'm just drowning in flour. And what you do, here's the the barley dump. Takes up to 500,000. I've got 113,000 left. There's the wheat dump, and there's the rye dump. And it's all on the same grape. But that does work with Courseplay. And the bread factory does not distinguish between barley, rye, wheat, barley flour, wheat flour, or rye flour. It treats them all exactly the same way. And the only reason to supply this factory with all three types of grain is to triple its output, because there's three conveyors. Anyway, but then you wind up with a situation eventually like this, which means I'm drowning in flour, because you produce way more flour than is needed for the bread factory. However, you can sell flour And what is flour going for at the moment? 5,538. Oh, can't really be bothered. You know what I mean? When you've got so much money in this game, you can't really be bothered continuing to play it because... anyway, whatever. So, another place which needs pallets. Anyway, I've shown you the flour factory and the bakery and the brewery. Let's go down to the refinery. Oh, shit, no. Oh, fucking dead. Get out of here. Man, what am I going to do? I've recorded too much to try it again. Okay, here we go. Getting out. Thank God I can still walk around. Okay, so here's the refinery, which you'll be able to find out where it is in your map if you play this game. And it takes raps, or sonneblumen. Sonneblumen obviously means sunflowers, and raps is canola. But acre for acre, you get more canola than you do sunflowers, and it treats it both the same, so it's only very, you know, I only ever feed it with canola. It produces compost and diesel, and you can sell diesel at the service stations, and that's what this does. But, you know, a good thing about this is the compost, which is delivered out of that pipe there. And at the moment, we've got 389,000. When it gets to 500,000, the whole factory stops working. Now, I've modded some of my trailers. Let's go to the shop and I'll show you. So that can hold 500,000 litres. And that, oh, no, wait there, which other one? No, yeah. And that one can hold 250,000 litres. This has gone down to 25 frames a second. 24, 25. So therefore you only need a couple of trips up here to feed this thing. Anyway, so that's where you get that. And it does really work out well. There's the brewery next door, which I've shown you. The bread factory is just up the road, and the flour factory. But if we want to go to the milk factory, this is the milk factory. Now, the milk factory requires, well, it's not a milk factory, the dairy product factory requires pure milk, which you get from your cows, and water, which you obviously know how to get it. I've got that there because anyway, in here, this is yogurt produced here. That's bloody Spiesel quark. What is it really? Looks like some sort of margarine, but you don't get margarine out of bloody milk. Anyway, butter, that's obvious. No, wait there. Whatever the fuck. Sorry, don't mean to swear. Vol milk, meaning low-fat milk, which is produced. And butter or something. I don't know. One of them's butter. I've already produced some of this stuff, and I always put it in a different place. But the real headache with this place is that you can't back pallet trucks in and pick things up, because there's the open doors, right? So when these are full, it becomes difficult to back the pallet trucks in to only pick up one product, because you know, you'll get them all mixed up. And that's why I've got this here, and that is not to forklift each and every one of the pallets out, but to push them in the direction of the bloody pallet collector. So, yeah, it's really hard. So you back it in here and it collects all of this product, and one of these will slip on. And I like to keep all my products separate. I don't want a mixed bag of anything. So I had to download a thing called Super Strength, which means I can actually pick these things up with me hands in order to stick them onto the bloody things. Forklifts, I can't lay the forklift mod. This is the biggest pallet collector you can get, but it's too long to really sell things at sell points with, because there's an overlap. Not all of it fits on. So, I have a particular trick to keep the price at exactly the same price for the entire sale, and that trick is to drive one medium-sized pallet loader into the loading area and then press unload, but don't unload it on either side, just unload it, and then the stuff starts disappearing as you're selling it, and then you can bring another tractor in full of the same stuff and park it right beside it, and when you're down to the last carton on the first tractor, then you suddenly press unload on your tractor, on your current tractor, and then drive the first tractor back, just take it out, I've still got one pallet left on it, take it back and pick up more, and then bring it back. And because the sell process is so slow, you can usually do it as long as you've got your products close to the sell point and not on the other side of the map. So I've bought a field way over there next to the two supermarkets and the stadium, where when these products build up, I take them off and dump them in that field with this big long loader. And that's the only reason for this loader, is because it can take these things over to my dump field. I'll show you. Where are we? Supermarket, bloody. Where are we? Yeah, okay, we'll go there. Visit. Anyway, I haven't got much left there. Really. Because I did sell everything because I was going to finish the game, but I thought before I'd finished, I'd show you how everything works. Anyway, let's go up to the place where you get the paper cartons. Oh, shit, let's go back to the milk. Visit. Okay, so to produce this yogurt and everything else, you need milk, and you need water, which I've shown you. But you also need empty wood pallets from the sawmill and paper roll pallets. Okay. Now, these are produced up here at Zelsterfabrik. And it needs water. I think 200 grams worth. And it produces over here cartons, cardboard cartons for the cherries, pears, apples and plums, and here are some paper pallets for the dairy products. So it uses water and wood chips, which you dump in here, and it takes about 500,000 of those. Sugar's pretty self-explanatory. If you can't work out sugar, you're a fucking idiot. So, sorry, but, you know, whatever. An Obst farm up here. This will pretty much do it. is where you've got your apples with your compost, and you dump your empty wood cartons there, and your empty wood pallets there, and your cardboard cartons there. Both produced at the carton factory, and that produces apples. Same story here, empty wood pallets and cartons, as well as compost, which, as you'll remember, was produced at the diesel making factory. And there we've got cherries, and up the end we've got plums. They also require water. So going up here, we'll see. Le Platten is empty wood pallets from the sawmill, and carton palatin is from up there at the cartons, at the carton and paper bloody producing factory. And there's the plums up there. So in here we've got plums, and we've got cherries, and we've got pears, and we've got apples. And they all sell for a certain amount at the shop. It's got a light switch too, but I've never been here at night. It's also a good idea to buy a short automatic pallet collector, which doesn't fit many pallets on, because if you try and back a long one, see this fence and these trees, it's a friggin' headache to try and get the pallets in. So they've all got their uses. The medium-sized pallet is to unload the beer, because you can just back it in and pick up all everything. The short pallet is to back, and the short pallet loading machine is to back things into tight areas, like putting the wood pallets into the beer, etc. So anyway, I'm not going to show you the harvesters or anything. So what else is interesting? The multi-storage sheds, but you know, you can find that out yourself. But that's how it all really works out. And I think, did I show you the foot of fabric? I think I did. Foot of fabric produces total mixed ration. No, blah, 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 blah. If I didn't, I'll do it next time. See you later.